Hello guys, welcome to this video. I will explain you how to make a simple dubstep track in a few and easy steps. To understand what follows, you should know at least the very basics and something about effects. In case you are in distress, there will be annotations on this video giving you some more help on what you need. Notice that to make a good dubstep, you need to try it over and over many times. This video will give you the basic hints, advices and a general idea about how to make it. Mind that you will need practice for your first time for sure. First of all, dubstep is a music genre that is in freeform styles. In short, there aren't very defined rules to make a dubstep track. All is made through inspiration and by hand. I will present you a general idea of how a dubstep track should be. But keep in mind that the basic structure can really vary. This is the project we will consider. This has been made by Ramon Guevara, a very awesome dubstep music producer. Visit his channel and subscribe him for more music. If you are interested in his project, check notations or the video description. To create a dubstep track, you have to go through several steps. First of all, you have to set the beats per minute. Then you will create your basic beats. Then you will add melodies and bass lines. When the track is good, you will add the wobble sound and an effect in the end. So, first of all, set the tempo. It is usually set between 137 and 145 BPM for a typical dubstep track. Even 70 BPM is accepted. The very first step is to set your basic beat background. This establishes the basic time of your track. Firstly, decide which kind of instrumental beats add, without caring about their note or frequency. That will be simply set later. Usually kicks, hi-hats, cymbals, snares and bass lines are commonly used. You must keep in mind that there aren't clear and generic rules to follow, so trust in your inspiration. In dubstep, such beats are put regular or more often irregular in rhythm, some of them even in offbeat, which means to be put in an unexpected time according to the listener, creating an effect called syncopation. The usage of different instrumental beats is very common, like two or more kicks totally overlapped to create more original output beats. To make your project, you can simply work through the arrangement view, dedicating one track for each beat and melody, easy to handle and build. However, this may be not good if you want to create more original and complex beats through an external controller or instrument. If you are a beginner or you want a fast beat to handle, you can use the beat generators available in Ableton, such as Impulse. If you don't know how to use such, check the video dedicated to the creation of beats in this show. How to put such beats? There aren't general rules here either. But let's simply make this. Make a text with kicks and a counterpart with hard claps, very regular. Make or not a basis with snares or hi-hats. Then put some more kicks or snares in between of the regular beats just added. You will obtain a nice dubstep beat. Then, with experience, you will be able to make beats better than this one. This is simply a startup. When the beat is made, make sure that this can be looped without problems when you try to stretch it. Change tempo if beats seems to be too slow or too fast. Dubstep doesn't use notes too much fast. How about the length? This set when your work is in a more advanced point. So just leave the beats as they are. Then you will stretch them or not later. If you want to add further beats that you want to manage one by one, add them in single tracks. For more advices, watch the video dedicated to beat making in this show. If you have further problems to find the right beat, there are some links that will let you download dubstep beats, so that you can get into this more easily. When you will know better this genre, you will right know which beats are good for a dubstep track and which aren't. Here, for example, it's use the impulse device to add all the beats in. Eventually you can add random beats as in this project, creating more syncopation. After making your basic beat, add some melody and bass line, better if in separated tracks. To create especially the melody, it's better to dedicate a MIDI track for each instrument that composes it. If you want to keep full control on them in terms of notes and effects. Then you will choose the instrument to make up your melody, a guitar, a violin, any kind of instrument is accepted in this genre. You will add bass lines later if you like, using MIDI tracks exactly in the same way as with the melodies, with the only difference that the instrument used is a bass or made through an Ableton device, so we will see the melody. A great way to add melodies is to use vacant MIDI tracks in the arrangement view, filling them later with notes and the related instrument chosen. Create a new MIDI clip in the session view and then record it in the arrangement view, as you could do with the beats before. Length is set later. Use then this new MIDI track to draw notes and add sample instruments. Or else you can generate such instrument through live generators. Watch the video dedicated to MIDI files in this show, in case you need help at this step. While you add the notes in the clip window, make sure to edit length notes by dragging their edges. It is fundamental to hear the melody over and over as much as with the beats. Play often the arrangement view and hear how the song goes on. Click on the numbers next to the filled tracks to make them sound or make them muted, and hear if beats created and melodies added do fit. This step may require some time and may oblige you to change something of the beats or the melodies themselves. You can use again impulse to make your melody with more instruments instead of one, as we have seen for beats. I'm showing you just an example about how to get through. The melody is totally created on your own. Follow the beat background you have created before and go on further with your project. You can make bass lines using the operator. This one will be explained in a while. Make sure to add a lot of bass lines, since they play a nice role in this genre. You must know that you are not obliged to add some melody or bass lines. You can avoid it, although your song can seem a bit poor and empty. When melody is done, you must add the protagonist of any kind of dubstep music, the wobble bass. It is called in this way because wob reflects the kind of sound at low frequency that seems to sing hard, like a soloist. Generally, a wob sound is made through a synth as well. The most used one is Massive by Native Instruments. A wob is made by putting together low frequency sine waves and squared ones, modulated in such a way to create an harsh bass sound effect. I won't explain Massive here because you need this plugin to use it. The wob sound can be made already through the live device generators that you have by default. Although in Massive you can make even more professional and original wobble effects. In the live devices list, pick up operator and drag it on the track you have the vacant MIDI track. At the bottom you will see the generator ready. We need this MIDI clip to add the wobble inside. Use the piano roll in the clip window to set the notes of your future wobble sound. Just put a low note, D1, C1, or even lower with a great length in time. Then go starting with the operator. To make easier the search of the right wobble, make sure to have the loop switch on to hear what follows. The operator is a 4-channel modulator with a low frequency oscillator or LFO and a low pass filter. Set the level of each channel for the intensity of each wave and set coarse and fine knobs to adjust their tone. For each channel, you can set the proper sound wave on the center, drawing the frequency spectrum of the channel selected. You can set it by hand in this way or choose through the selection below wave. Usually, adding a sine wave makes your output more smooth, whereas a square wave makes just the opposite. I will show you the simpler way to create a wobble sound. First of all, fill the four channels with two square waves and two sine waves. So in the channel A, put the square D spectrum from the wave section and do the same with the B channel. Then fill C and D channels with a very low sine wave. If you choose a sin in the wave section, it should appear by default. The sound obtained has too many high frequency components to be a wobble sound, so turn on the filter section and choose a low pass. You will set the filter pole and the amount while hearing the sound over and over. Now turn on the channel through the 11 knobs and put a higher level amount of square and sine waves until you feel approaching a very bass sound. The sound you will obtain is plain and never changes, so just turn LFO on and make sure that the low frequency oscillation is applied just to the filter and not on the channels, and put sync by clicking here. Now set the amount of the low oscillation and the wobble effect is done. You can edit your wobble sound precisely. Increase the rate of the LFO to make it move faster. It is commonly used to move this rate throughout the song using automations. Just right-click on the rate and click on Show Automation. If you need help, just watch the video about automations in this show. Put an higher amount to make the wobble harsher. Then change the course of each channel to change the kind of wobble bass. Do not put too much high course value, or you will get too much distortion. Once you're done, you can come back to the piano roll to change the notes of the wobble sound. This obviously won't change at all the tone and the kind of wobble created. You can add more than a single bass. Use multiply operator tracks to manage wobble sounds in a more independent way. Once you have made beats, wob, and basic melody, you can put them together to create your song. In dubstep, it is very common the use of the pauses. For example, when the song goes with melodies and bassline, usually in dubstep it is put then a sick pause when another instrument can play solo. And then, after the pause, the song may start again with the wob wob, and then pause again with a voice, and then start it again. At this point the track is done. You can further make it better adding effects that you like. In dubstep it is used a lot the reverb and the echo delay effect on beats such as snares and hi-hats. You can give echo to your beats too. Later you can add further melodies to fill remaining empty parts of your project. As the last step, never forget to check the quality of the final sound. Adjust to high spikes using the limiter and the compressor, and use equalizer to observe it and delete frequencies that you don't like. Often hear dubstep tracks to know how they are and which bass and beats should be more appropriate. Hear the difference between using such or not. So finally your dubstep should start working. Thanks for watching this tutorial. Take a look in the video description to get a basic dubstep track template. This is a demo version from the work offered by Ramon Guevara. If you like it, you can ask his project directly from him. And don't forget to check him out. See you!